Tourism has the potential of being the number one industry in the state of Oklahoma. And Oklahoma, in turn, has the potential of becoming a leader in the tourism industry by recognizing and promoting an untapped resource in this state. According to the Price Waterhouse study of Oklahoma's tourism and recreation potential, that resource is a vast Native American presence here. Through promotion of the diverse cultural heritage provided by the state's 37 Indian tribes, and by developing and strengthening tribal economic enterprises, Oklahoma's economy can receive a much-needed boost, a goal shared by all who work, live, and play in this state. The Muscogee Creek Nation and other Oklahoma Indian tribes that are already playing a significant role in the state's economy and the tourism industry through the operation of very popular entertainment facilities known as bingo halls. Currently, there are 28 tribally operated bingo halls in the state with an estimated gross annual revenue of $104 million. These facilities have a combined seating capacity of 22,000 patrons and boast an annual attendance over 2.8 million people. This industry provides over 1,200 jobs in this state with an annual payroll in excess of $6 million. The number of non-resident tourists visiting tribal bingo operations is approximately 400,000 people yearly, with an estimated expenditure of $135 per person for lodging, meals, and other activities. Those figures provide us with a total of $54 million tourism dollars per year coming into the state. That's economic impact. Creek Nation has been in the bingo business since 1984, when the tribe opened its first bingo facility on tribal land along the Arkansas River in Tulsa. Since then, three other tribally licensed bingo halls have opened in the Creek Nation. First came the Bristow Bingo Hall, owned and operated by the Bristow Indian community. Then the Okmulgee Bingo Facility was established as a tribally operated business venture. The most recent hall to open is located in Eufaula and is operated by the Eufaula Indian community. But the tribe's major economic tourist attraction is the Tulsa Bingo Hall. Average daily attendance at this facility exceeds 1,000 persons, of which approximately 10% come from out of state. Players compete for over $50,000 in cash and prizes daily, and about $11 million in prizes are given away each month. As with all of Creek Nation's bingo operations, this facility is modern, clean, attractive, and air-conditioned. All gaming operations are internally regulated by Creek Nation Gaming Commission. Creek Nation Gaming Commissioner Bill Foster explains the function of the tribe's gaming commission.
It's the responsibility of the Office of Public Gaming of the Creek Nation that we overview and monitor the total operation of the facility for the benefit of the public as well as benefit of the Creek Nation. We're looking at the fact that the advertising is correct, that whatever is advertised is offered to the public. We're looking at the fact that the games are played honestly, the fact that the Creek Nation receives its proper share of the net return.
In the immediate future, Creek Nation will be embarking on a new bingo venture, an interstate tribal satellite bingo network. This innovative enterprise was featured recently on Tulsa's KOTV Channel 6 News.
Mega Bingo is the name of the new satellite bingo game the Creek Nation plans to broadcast around the nation next month. Players at the Creek Bingo Hall will be able to compete with players on Indian reservations in 12 other states for a $500,000 prize. By the first of the year, as other Indian bingo halls join in, the Creeks plan to up the main prize to $1 million.
We're convinced that this is going to be real exciting, and we think once we get started on this, we're anticipating, and maybe I'm letting the cat out of the bag, but we think we're going to have a millionaire every 10 to 12 days somewhere in the United States.
The bingo hall already attracts more than 400,000 people a year, and the high-stakes satellite games are expected to boost attendance even higher.
Your first is fantastic, and I'm going to be the first one at the door.
Well, it's exciting. Anything about bingo is exciting.
Yeah, it's better than lottery, let's put it that way.
Satellite Mega Bingo means big profits for the Creek Nation. The tribe expects to make an extra $1 million per year on the satellite games. Rick Peterson, Channel 6 News.
And Creek Nation is planning to move into tourism entertainment industry in an even bigger way in the near future with the development and construction of an outdoor theme park called Oklahoma Heritage. Theme parks have become an integral part of the American way of life as well as the international tourism industry. Attendance at theme parks in the United States exceed 100 million people annually and provide a significant attraction to foreign visitors. Capitalizing on the findings of the Price Waterhouse study, Creek Nation's proposed park will feature the best of Oklahoma's Western heritage and the unique Native American cultures. The proposed site is just west of Sapulpa on the north side of Turner Turnpike, providing good access from both Tulsa and Oklahoma City. This 650-acre site has outstanding visibility from the turnpike, containing gently rolling wooded hills, scenic bluffs, and a small lake, all features contributing to an ideal entertainment location. The park will provide the visitor with a mix of entertainment, history, and Indian culture, starting with the Creek Indian area. This area will feature living exhibits of ancient Creek village life, stickball games, and stomp dance exhibitions. A children's adventure river ride and log flume rides may also be included. The Frontier Western area will provide visitors with the flavor of the Old West of Oklahoma Territory days, including a train ride, rodeo arena, shooting arcade, and more. Another Indian area will focus on the culture and traditions of other Oklahoma Indians, with care given to culturally accurate and sensitive presentations. Indian foods and fine art items will be available, and a canoe rapids ride may also be included. Finally, there's the old Boomtown area, featuring a turn-of-the-century Main Street, vintage car rides, mine train ride, shops, and other attractions. An amphitheater and floating stage will add even more variety to the park, along with a big-screen IMAX movie theater. The total site development and construction budget is over $40 million. A feasibility study for the park, commissioned by the Creek Nation Tribal Government, anticipates a first-year attendance of almost 800,000 people and a gross annual revenue in excess of $17 million. Over 1,300 jobs will be created by the park, with an annual payroll of over $7 million. As you can see, Oklahoma is a natural for tourism destinations involving Indians, Indian tribes, and Indian culture. And a new spirit of cooperation, dissolving antagonisms of the past, has begun to appear as we strive for a common goal.
In what appears to be an act of surrender, the State Tourism Department says it wants to help promote high-stakes Indian bingo. Tourism Marketing Director Eugene Dilbeck told the Oklahoma Indian Gaming Commission today they need to work together to publicize bingo to the rest of the country.
So we're wanting to form a strong partnership with you and to sit down and see how we can come up with the right types of promotions.
For years, the state has fought Indian bingo operations. The jackpots exceeded state limits, and the bingo halls didn't pay state sales taxes. But this year, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled the state couldn't collect sales taxes on the games. And this week, President Reagan signed legislation that tribes believe will make it even tougher for the state to interfere with bingo. So with the battle apparently over, the tourism department is jumping on the bingo bandwagon.
And what's so interesting is that the greatest number of inquiries we're getting are from people in Florida and down in the southeast wanting to come to Oklahoma, bring people up here for the bingo.
The change in attitude was well received.
I think that's an intelligent point of view to know when the issue's over. And
it's taken several hard years to bring to everyone's attention that Indian activities are beneficial to everyone within the state.
To help publicize the games, Dilbeck urged the tribes to publish an Indian bingo directory and said the tourism department could distribute up to 300,000 copies. Rick Peterson, Channel 6 News.
Through the unified efforts of strong and stable tribal governments like the Creek Nation and the state of Oklahoma and members of the Oklahoma travel industry, tourism can play a significant role in the state's economic recovery, with financial benefits to all those involved.